Hi students, welcome back to your chemistry class. See, today we are going to discuss about same chapter 3, atoms and molecules. Today we are going to discuss about problems based on this lesson. Okay. Finally, in our previous class we have discussed about that is calculation of molecular masses and also molar mass calculation and moles calculation, then mass calculation and finally number of particles calculation, isn't it? Today we are going to discuss about the problems based on these topics. Okay, see, listen. What is called molecular mass and what is formula unit mass? See, we have discussed in previous class that is molecular mass. See, it is the sum of atomic mass of all the atoms present in a molecule. Sum of atomic mass of all the atoms present in a molecule. Then how will you represent this molecular mass with the help of unit? That is U, unified mass. Is it clear? So based on this, we are going to calculate the molecular mass of given compounds, that is H2, hydrogen and chlorine Cl2 and NH3 ammonia and then C2H4. That is, what is it? C2H4. It is one of the carbon compounds, that is ethane. Not ethane, it is ethene and CH3OH methanol. CH3OH, it is methanol or methyl alcohol. So for hydrogen and then chlorine and also what's that? NH3 ammonia and then same like this ethane and methyl alcohol. For these compounds, today we are going to discuss about the molecular mass calculation. See, next it is given, calculate the formula unit mass of zinc oxide, sodium oxide and K2CO3, that is potassium carbonate. And how will you calculate the formula unit mass? This formula unit mass also, we will calculate same like molecular masses. But what's the difference? Mostly we will calculate these formula unit masses for ionic compounds. See, what are the ions present in this zinc oxide? Zinc 2 plus and O2 minus. Zinc ion and also oxide ion. And same like this, Na plus sodium ion. Here 2 sodium, so 2 Na plus and O2 minus because the oxygen valence is 2. And then see here potassium carbonate K plus. Here 2 potassium, 2 K plus and CO3 2 minus. So suppose if they are asking, what are the ions present in this following component? You have to write what are the ions present here. So positive ion as well as negative ion. So like this, ionic compounds we will calculate with the help of formula unit mass. This formula unit mass also we are calculating like the molecular masses, the sum of all the atoms present in this given formula. So for this also the unit is U, that is unified mass. So see here, now we are going to discuss one by one. We calculate the molecular mass of H2. That is how we calculate the molecular mass of H2. How we calculate? See, 2 hydrogen. So 2 hydrogen. So hydrogen, the atomic mass is 1. So this is 2 unified mass. Same like this, what is the molecular mass of chlorine? Cl2. See here, we know very well, this gas is like fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, we will represent in the form of a molecule. So it is Cl2. So how will you represent? It is 2 chlorine present here. So 2 into, what's the atomic mass of chlorine means? It is 35.5. 35.5 is the atomic mass. So it is 2 into 35.5. It is 71 unified mass. 71 unified mass. Then we are going to discuss about molecular mass of NH3. What is NH3? See, NH3. So for ammonia. And see here, this ammonia, how do you write? So, 1 nitrogen in this ammonia, 1 nitrogen. So, 14 is the atomic mass. And then, 3 hydrogen. So 3 into 1. So totally 17 unified mass. And same like this, next molecular mass of C2H4. That is ethene. That is ethene. So for this ethene, how will you calculate C2H4? 2 carbon. So 2 into carbon atomic mass is 12. Then 4 hydrogen. So 4 into hydrogen atomic mass is 1. So 12, 2s are 24 plus 4, that is 26 unified mass. Isn't it? So 12 into 2, 24 plus 4, 26 unified mass. And finally, CH3OH. So molecular mass of CH3OH is equal to, how will you calculate? See, 1 carbon. So 12, then 3 hydrogen. So 3 into 1, so totally 3 and 1 oxygen. How many oxygen? 1 oxygen. Oxygen atomic mass is 16 and 1 hydrogen again, it is 1. So see here, 1 carbon 12, 3 hydrogen 3, 1 oxygen 16 and 1 hydrogen again, it is 1. So how will you calculate totally? 12 plus 3, 15 and 16 plus 16, that is 32 unified mass. What is this? 32 unified mass. So this is the calculation of molecular mass of given compounds. We can calculate the molecular mass based on the atomic mass. Sum of atomic mass of all the atoms present in a molecule is called, it is molecular mass. Isn't it? So how will you calculate all the molecular mass for this given compound? For that you have to know the atomic masses. So what's the atomic mass of hydrogen? It is 1. What's the atomic mass of chlorine? 35.5. What's the atomic mass for nitrogen? 14 unified mass. What's the atomic mass for carbon? 12 unified mass. And what is the atomic mass for oxygen? 16 unified mass. So you have to know the atomic mass first. Then only we can calculate the molecular mass. So what's the unit of this molecular mass calculation? U, it is unified mass. U, it is unified mass. So this is the calculation of molecular masses of given compounds. And then you see the second formula, what is given? Calculate the formula unit mass of zinc oxide, sodium oxide, as well as potassium carbonate. So how will you calculate formula unit mass? See here, for that formula unit mass, here it is given zinc. What's the atomic mass? In question itself, it is given 65 unified mass. And sodium, 23 unified mass. Then potassium, 39 unified mass. Then carbon, 12 unified mass. Oxygen, 16 unified mass. So based on this, we have to calculate this formula unit mass. So listen, how will you calculate these formula unit masses? This also same calculation, the sum of atomic mass of all the atoms present in a given formula. That is, for ionic compounds, we are going to calculate this formula unit masses. So first one, what is given? It is zinc oxide, isn't it? Zinc oxide. So how will you calculate? For it is only one zinc. What's the atomic mass for zinc? See here, 65 unified mass. What's this? Zinc, 65 unified mass. And for oxygen, it is 16 unified mass. So totally 70 and then 81 unified mass is the 81 unified mass is the formula unit mass of zinc oxide. Formula unit mass of zinc oxide. Formula unit mass of zinc oxide is 81 unified mass. The calculation is same like that of molecular mass. Unit also same like that of molecular mass. But what's the difference between this formula unit mass and molecular mass calculation means? Here in formula unit mass, we are using for ionic compounds. Is it clear? And then next is sodium oxide. Sodium oxide. See, sodium oxide. How many sodium is present here? 2 sodium. So 2 into sodium atomic mass is given here. See, 23 unified mass. 23 unified mass. Plus oxygen only. 1 oxygen. So 16. And then 23 into 2, it is 46. 46 plus 16. 46, 52 and 62 unified marks. That is 62 unified marks. As the formula, unit mass of sodium oxide. What is the ions present in the sodium oxide? That is sodium ion. See here, zinc ion and oxide ion. Here zinc ion and oxide ion. See here, sodium ion and oxide ion. Two sodium. So sodium ion and oxide ion. See, so next what is given? K2PO3. That is potassium carbonate. So here, how many potassium is here? That is 2 potassium. What's the atomic mass for potassium? It is given here 39 unified mass. So see, first what are the ions present in this potassium? That is K. 2 potassium ions are there and the carbonate ion CO3 2 minus. Positive ion is K plus, that is potassium ion, and negative ion anion is carbonate ion. So see here, calculate, and 2 into what is the atomic mass of potassium? 39 unified mass. So 2 into 39, then plus carbon, so it is carbon 12 unified mass, then plus oxygen 3 into 16. 3 into 16. So see here, this is 78 plus 12 plus 16 into 3, that is 3 16s are 42 plus 16, 30, 3 6 are 18, that is 48, isn't it? So add this, how you add 8, 10, 18, 5, 6, 13. So totally 138 unified mass. What is this? 138 unified mass as the what's the mass of potassium? Formula, unit mass of potassium carbonate, it is 138 unified mass. That is 138 unified mass. Okay. See, listen, this is the formula unit mass. So what's the ions present in this potassium carbonate? Anion, that is CO3 2 minus carbonate ion. And cation, potassium ion, K plus. Is it clear? So, this is the calculation of molecular mass calculation as well as formula unit mass calculation. Molecular mass as well as formula unit mass calculation. So, both calculation also same, but only the differences between the molecular mass and formula unit mass. For molecular mass, we are going to apply the sum of atomic mass of all the atoms present in given molecule. But in formula unit mass, same the sum of atomic mass present in the given formula unit. That is, for ionic compounds, we will apply this. That's it. So, this is the calculation of molecular mass as well as formula unit mass. Next, we are going to calculate about, that is, molar mass calculation. Just listen. We are going to discuss about molar mass calculation. So, listen. Next, we are going to calculate about molar mass calculation. See, calculate the molar mass of the following. What is this molar mass of following? It is given C2H2, S8, C4, HCl and HNO3. What is this C2H2? That is ethyne. And S8, sulfur molecule. And C4, phosphorus molecule. And HCl, hydrochloric acid, that is hydrogen chloride. And HNO3, nitric acid, or hydrogen nitrate, isn't it? So, for this now we are going to calculate about molar masses. See, how will you calculate molar mass? What is called the molar mass? The mass of one mole of any substance is called molar mass of the substance. Mass of one mole of any substance is equal to that molar mass of that substance. We know very well the quantity of substance we will calculate with the help of molar mass. So, automatically quantity means what's the unit for this molar mass? It is G. So, we know very well what's the difference between molecular mass calculation as well as molar mass calculation means. only the unit is different. In molecular mass calculation, the unit is U, that is unified mass, but in molar mass calculation, the unit is changes U to G. Okay, so see here, now we are going to discuss about the molar mass of C2H2. So what's the molar mass of? Molar mass of C2H2. So how many carbon? It is 2 carbon, 2 into 12 plus here 2 hydrogen, so it is 2. So 24 plus 2, it is 26, but unit is not U, it is G, it is gram. So what's the difference in molar mass and molecular mass? The unit is different. For molecular mass, the unit is U, unified mass, but molar mass, we are calculating the quantity of substance, so the unit is G. Okay, and then next, that is sulfur SH. Sulfur SH. So 8 atoms of sulfur. 8 into what is the atomic mass of sulfur? That is 32. Atomic number we know very well. For sulfur it is 16 and atomic mass is 32 unified mass. 32 unified mass. So 8 atoms of sulfur combined to form sulfur molecule. So 8 into 32, that is 256 gram. What's this molar mass of sulfur? That is 8 into 32, that is 256 gram. Same like this. Next we are going to calculate about P4. This is phosphorus molecule. This is phosphorus molecule, that is 4 atoms of phosphorus. 4 atoms of phosphorus to form phosphorus molecule. So 4 into, we know very well, atomic number of phosphorus is 15. Here this is atomic mass, it is 31. So it is 4 into 31. So it is 124 grams. 4 threes are 12 and 14 is 4. So 124 grams is the molar mass for phosphorus. As well as next we are going to discuss about HCl, that is hydrogen chloride or hydrochloric acid. That is for hydrogen chloride, HCl. So how will you write? For one hydrogen, that is H, it is 1, and chlorine, it is 35.5 unified mass. So totally 36.5 gram. 36.5 gram of the, what is that? Molar mass of HCl. And finally, HNO3, hydrogen nitrate or nitric acid, HNO3. For one hydrogen, it is 1, and one nitrogen, it is 14, and 3 oxygen. So 3 into 16. So 15 plus 48. So 4, 5, 15, and 58, and 63. So for nitric acid, molar mass for nitric acid is 63 grams. So listen carefully. And how will you calculate the molar mass for given compound? Molar mass calculation is mass of 1 mole of any substance is equal to molar mass of that substance. See, here it is given C2H2 and SH, P4, HCl and nitric acid. For molar mass for C2H2, it is ethyne and 2 carbon and 2 hydrogen is present here. So, what is that carbon? It is carbon atom, atomic masses, it is, what's the carbon atomic mass? 12. So, 12 unified mass is the atomic mass for carbon, but here we will use gram atomic mass, that is 12 gram, and hydrogen also, gram atomic mass is 2 gram. So, totally 26 gram is the molar mass of C2H2. Same like this, next the sulfur molecule. Sulfur, 8 atoms of sulfur combined to form sulfur molecule. So, S8. This is S8. So, 8 atoms of sulfur. So, 1 sulfur, the atomic mass is 32. Here it is gram atomic mass, 32 gram. So, 8 into 32, it is 256 gram of the molar mass of sulfur. As well as phosphorus, 4 atoms of phosphorus combined to form, it is phosphorus molecule. So, 4 into atomic mass for phosphorus is 31. Here we are using gram, atomic mass is 31 gram. So totally 124 gram is the molar mass of phosphorus molecule. As well as here, HCl, it is one hydrogen and one chlorine. So chlorine atomic mass is 35.5, here gram atomic mass 35.5 gram. So totally 36.5 gram is the mass of molar mass of chlorine, hydrogen chloride. Same like this, finally nitric acid and one hydrogen, three oxygen is present here. So totally 63 gram is the molar mass of nitric acid. So how will you calculate molecular mass and formula unit mass and molar mass? The calculation is same, only the difference in molecular mass and formula unit mass. That is, for formula unit mass we are using for only ionic compounds, and here molar mass, the unit is changed from U to G. So next we are going to discuss about one more problem. Listen carefully. See, at 0.24 gram sample of compound of oxygen and boron was found by analysis to contain 0.096 gram of boron and 0.144 gram of oxygen. So calculate the percentage composition of the compound by weight. Now we need to calculate the percentage composition of the compound by weight. So how will you calculate? First we need to calculate one by one, step by step. We need to calculate both percentage of boron as well as percentage of oxygen. For that we have to know the formula. It is weight of boron by weight of sample into 100. So weight of atom, what is here, we are taking boron as well as oxygen. So weight of boron and weight of sample into 100. See, what is weight of boron is here? 0.096. So 0.096. And what's the weight of sample is given here? 0.24 gram of sample. So it is 0.24 into 100. So finally, we will get 40% of boron. And then, now we need to calculate the percentage of oxygen. How will you calculate the percentage of oxygen? Same formula. Weight of oxygen by weight of sample into 100. So what is weight of oxygen is given here? That is 0.144 gram. And what's the weight of sample? 0.24 into 100. So finally we will get 60%. So like that we have to calculate the percentage composition of the compound by weight. What's the formula for calculating percentage composition of compound? That is weight of given compound by weight of sample into 100. That is weight of given atom. What we need to calculate, whether it is boron, we need to write boron. Whether it is oxygen, we need to write oxygen. Whether we need to write sodium, we need to write sodium. So weight of any element, what is given, weight of any element we need to write. Then weight of sample into 100. Finally, we will get the percentage composition of the given compound. Is it clear? So this is molar mass calculation and this is percentage composition of the compound by weight. Now we are going to discuss about the that is moles calculation and also number of atoms calculation one by one. Listen. See, next problem we are going to discuss about, that is one mole of carbon atoms weighs 12 grams. What is the mass of one atom of carbon? Listen the question carefully. Here it is given, one mole of carbon atoms weighs 12 gram. So 1 mole is equal to, carbon is equal to 12 gram is given. Then what is the mass of one atom of carbon? We have to calculate the mass of one atom of carbon. So you know very well, 1 mole of carbon is equal to 12 gram is given here. So this is 1 mole of any substance is equal to, what is that? Avogadro number of particles. 1 mole of any substance is equal to Avogadro number of particles. So 1 mole of carbon is equal to 12 grams, that is equal to 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 atoms, that means which is equal to Avogadro number of particles, isn't it? So 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 atoms of carbon weighs 12 grams. So 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 gram of carbon weighs 12 grams. That means one atom of carbon, how will you calculate? One atom of carbon is equal to 12 grams divided by 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 is equal to 1.99 into 10 to the power minus 23 grams. So this is one atom of carbon. So So, 1 mole of any substance is equal to Avogadro number of particles. So, that means 1 atom of carbon means that is given weight, that is 12 divided by Avogadro number of particles. We will get the answer. This is the 1 atom of carbon. And same like this, here it is given one more problem to you, which has more number of atoms. Whether 100 gram of sodium, 100 gram of sodium or 100 gram of iron, which has more number of atoms. How will you calculate? For that, we need to calculate, we have to know about number of atoms, means we need to calculate number of moles. Why we need to calculate number of moles? Here it is, we need to calculate only number of atoms only, you know. For that, we have to calculate number of moles, because number of moles is equal to number of atoms. That means 12 gram of carbon atoms is equal to, what is it? 12 gram of moles, carbon moles. So 1 mole of any substance is equal to Avogadro number of particles. Same like this, number of atoms also is equal to a number of moles. Number of atoms also is equal to number of moles. So if we can calculate number of moles, we can identify what is the number of atoms. Whether number of moles are high, number of atoms are also high. Number of moles are low, number of atoms are also low. So based on this, now we are going to calculate number of moles. How will you calculate number of moles? That is given mass by molar mass. How will you calculate number of moles? Given mass by molar mass. What is given mass here for sodium? First number of moles of sodium. What is given mass? 100. So what is molar mass? Sodium 23. So 4.34 moles. Same like this. What is given mass for iron here? 100 gram. And what is the molar mass for iron? It is 56. If we will cancel, we will get 24 and divided by 14. And finally, we are getting the answer 1.79 moles. So compare these two. So sodium and iron. Sodium has more number of moles. 4.34 compared to iron. So which has more number of atoms? Means sodium has more number of atoms compared to iron, because sodium has more number of moles. So which has more number of moles? That only has automatically more number of atoms. So see here, what's the answer? Sodium has more number of atoms. Sodium has more number of atoms. So this is the answer. So how will you calculate which has more number of atoms? Means for that we need to calculate number of moles, because number of moles is equal to number of atoms. So number of moles is high, atoms are also high. Number of moles is low, atoms are also automatically low. So by calculating number of moles, we can identify the number of atoms. So based on this iron and sodium, sodium has more number of atoms because it has more moles compared to iron. Is it clear? So next we are going to calculate the number of aluminium ions present in 0.051 gram of aluminium oxide. So how will you calculate the number of aluminium ions? So we have formula for calculation of number of particles. Number of particles. What's the formula? Number of particles, whether atoms or molecules or ions. Number of particles, whether it is atoms or molecules or ions, we have one formula. What is that? Given mass by molar mass into Avogadro number. What's that? Given mass by molar mass into Avogadro number. What is given mass here? That is 0.051 divided by molar mass. How will you calculate the molar mass for aluminium oxide? That is Al2O3. 2 aluminium. So aluminium atomic mass is 27. That means 54 plus 3 into oxygen 16. So 48. So 90, it is 102 grams is the molar mass for aluminium oxide. So right here, 102. So given mass 0.051 divided by molar mass. Molar mass for aluminium oxide is 102 into Avogadro number 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. Is it clear? Okay. Now, what will you get? Finally, we will get that is 0.051 is given. We will get 3.011 into 10 to the power 20 you will get finally. Okay. This is number of ions only we have calculated, number of particles or number of ions. But see, the question calculate number of aluminium ions present in aluminium oxide. Aluminium ions present in aluminium oxide. See, what's the atomic mass for aluminium? 27. What's the atomic mass for aluminium ions? Same 27. So see here, how many atoms of aluminium here? 2 aluminium. So here it is calculated, we have calculated for 1 aluminium. So whether we have 2 aluminium, so 2 into 3.01 in 10 to the power 20. So automatically we will get 6.022 into 10 to the power 20. So number of aluminium present in aluminium oxide is 6.022 into 10 to the power 20. So how will you calculate? We have formula, number of particle calculation, atoms or molecules or ions. We have given mass by molar mass into Avogadro number. So what is given mass? 0.051. What is molar mass? It is 102 grams. And into Avogadro number, what is Avogadro number? 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. So finally, we'll get this is the answer. And from this, we need to calculate aluminium ions in aluminium oxide. So aluminium oxide has how many aluminium atom? That is 2. Aluminium atom, it is 2. So 2 aluminium ions are there. So 2 into given answer. So we can get 6.022 into 10 to the power 20 is the answer. Is it clear? Okay. And then next, we are going to calculate. See. Listen. Next question. Give the names of elements present in the following. See, give the names of elements present in the following. In that first, quicklime, hydrogen bromide, hydrogen, what's this? Quicklime, hydrogen bromide, then baking powder, baking, hydrogen bromide, baking powder, then potassium sulfate, potassium sulfate, and then finally carbon dioxide. Listen, see, this is one more question. How will you calculate? Give the names of elements present in the following. How will you write the, what are the elements present in this following? Say, what is quicklime? It is given. What's the name of elements present in this quicklime? You have to know the chemical name of quicklime. That is, chemical name of quicklime is calcium oxide. What is that formula? Calcium oxide. That is CaO. Calcium oxide. That is CaO. See, what's the answer? That is, give the names of elements present in the following. Here, calcium and oxygen. So what are the elements present in this? Calcium and oxygen. Same like this. See here, hydrogen bromide. Hydrogen bromide. What are the elements present here? Hydrogen and bromine. Only two. Hydrogen and bromine. As well as baking powder. For this, you have to know the chemical name of baking powder. What is that? Sodium hydrogen carbonate. sodium hydrogen carbonate, that is NaHCO3. So what are the names of elements present here? That is sodium hydrogen, then carbon and oxygen. See, what are the elements present in this? Sodium, hydrogen, carbon as well as oxygen. Same like this, what are the elements present in potassium sulfate? What's the formula for potassium sulfate? That is K2SO4. And what are the elements present in potassium sulfate? Potassium, sulfur and oxygen. Same like this, carbon dioxide, CO2. So only carbon and oxygen. So like this, you have to write the names of elements present in the given substance, means you have to know the chemical name. From that you can identify. Quicklime, it is calcium oxide, calcium and oxygen is present. Hydrogen bromide, hydrogen and bromine is present. Baking powder, that is NaHCO3, sodium hydrogen carbonate. So sodium is present, hydrogen is present, carbon is present and oxygen is present. Four elements are present here. Then potassium sulfate, potassium, sulfur and oxygen, and carbon dioxide, carbon and oxygen. So like this, you have to write the answer for this question. So dear children, so today we have discussed about molecular mass calculation as well as formula unit mass calculation as well as molar mass calculation. So how will you calculate these three calculations? All these three you have to calculate based on the sum of atomic masses present in the given compounds. For molecular mass, we can calculate for given molecules. And for formula unit mass, we need to calculate for given ionic compounds. And then for molar mass, we have to calculate for given molar compounds. That is, only the unit is different, that is unified mass to gram. Okay, and same like this, we have discussed about, that is percentage composition also, and we have discussed a number of atoms based on that, which has more number of atoms. For that we need to calculate number of moles. From number of moles we can identify number of atoms. And same like this, we have discussed about number of ions calculation. So number of ions, we have formula given must be molar mass in Avogadro number. So based on this we need to calculate. And see, in aluminium oxide we have two aluminium ions. So 2 into that answer we will get the final answer. Is it clear? And how will you write the names of elements from given compounds? First you have to know the chemical name. From that you can identify what are the elements present in the given compounds. For example, baking powder means you have to know what is the chemical name of baking powder. What's the chemical name? Sodium hydrogen carbonate. So NaHCO3. So what are the elements present? Sodium, hydrogen, carbon as well as oxygen. Same like this, you have to know the chemical name of quicklime, calcium oxide, calcium and oxygen. So like this you have to try to answer for these questions. Is it clear, children? And so see to that, if you have any doubts, we will discuss in your next class. Okay children, thank you.